Let's think for a bit about the patients who are already on drugs for their type 2 diabetes. This is something I've worried about quite a lot over the years, and particularly at the beginning, I was very concerned. So that actually, it might for many of you be quite a good thing to start with some of the easier cases, and then, like me, you will gain confidence as the years go by and learn what for you feels comfortable. So for me, I actually was very cautious, and years ago I started just with the pre-diabetics, and then I moved on to people with type 2 diabetes, and then my next phase was people on metformin. And I discovered actually that it works reasonably well as the weight comes down and the hemoglobin A1Cs improve. Once you're getting somewhere around maybe 47 to 50 millimoles per mole of hemoglobin A1C, you can start cutting the metformin. Now, this has to be seen against the patient's views, as in all of these things. You work in collaboration with the patient, so you've got your own goal, but don't forget the patient's goals or anxieties. So that, again, going back to that metformin, some patients already have side effects with metformin, particularly loose motions, that kind of, that's very common. So those patients are keen to give it up, and I factor that in. But usually, I'm cutting it down by about half, perhaps just leaving them with their morning dose of metformin, and then let's do another hemoglobin A1C 2 months later. But it does depend on how much weight they're losing. If they're doing really well, you might consider stopping it altogether. And all advice against what you're doing with drugs for diabetes would depend upon extra factors like, have they got a blood sugar meter? Because patients with blood sugar meters, you can act faster because you're getting feedback and you know how they're doing. So I think after that, my next group were those on glycoside. Now, glycoside, one of its side effects is weight gain. So for many patients, they're interested in giving up glycoside because of the advantages of that. So far, in my own experience, for somebody losing weight, I've given up the glycoside totally early on. And I've so far not regretted that, so that if somebody's really taking up the low carb thing and understands, I might stop the glycoside altogether, in a more dramatic sense than I do the metformin. Of course, after that, there are whole other levels of extra drugs, perhaps culminating in insulin. Now, I didn't do anything with people on insulin with type 2 diabetes for the first couple of years because I was so anxious about that. But then again, looking at the effect of insulin in type 2 diabetes, it's perhaps unfortunate that it causes weight gain, and the studies show that insulin is not always the best idea in type 2 diabetes and brings with it real risks of its own. So that again, in partnership with the patients, reducing insulin can be exactly what they would like to do. How you do this depends on factors like how reliable is this patient? If they're on insulin, they should be measuring blood sugars. Are they doing it? When are they measuring those blood sugars? One of my partners pointed out that he found his patients were measuring blood sugars first thing in the morning, not after they'd had food. So the results they were bringing in were causing errors. So are your patients, when are they measuring their blood sugars? And then are they, how interested are they in reducing the insulin in a step-like manner while watching the blood sugars? And also, I suppose you would have to share with the patients, you're more concerned about a low blood sugar, them going hypo, than you are about it going a bit high. So one or two slight worries I've had with patients is where they've been too keen, the blood sugars dropped low, and these are people driving cars or whatever. So I've now tend to err slightly on the idea that it's a low blood sugar would worry me more than it going high. And it's difficult to be more specific than that because each case depends upon all of those various factors. I'd probably finish off by saying those people who were on insulin for type 2 diabetes are the group who are most proud of their achievements and are amazed when they can actually stop injecting. So it is work that's worth doing, although it does take more appointments because you're watching them more closely. But it can be very, very rewarding to try, as long as it's what your patient is really interested in.